All y'all bitches be confusing. So no love to her, Trisha, you stupid. Fell in love with the diamonds and Cubans. Said you love me, but you lying, you boofing. Fuck these bitches, it's back to the music. Middle finger and that's what the deuce is. Little bitch, you a W, I'm pulling. See the way how you bitches be moving. All y'all bitches be confusing. So no love to her, Trisha, you stupid. Fell in love with the diamonds and Cubans. Said you love me, but you.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Jay, and I'm back at it with another banger. Now, in today's video, I will be showing you guys the best shot creator build in NBA 2K19. Now, I have two gameplay for you guys to show you guys how that build play, how good it is. And at the end of this video, I will be showing you guys how I made this archetype, all right? Now, to me, I feel like this shot creator right here is the best one in the game. It's a shot creating primary, three-point shooting secondary. Now, I say that because you can iso with this build, as you finna see right here. Like, you can break ankles, your ankle breaker silver. You can still do the stuff a shot creator do, as you guys see the spin jump. You can still do all that. Your dunking is great, your shooting is great, and your dribbling is great. Now, with this archetype, you do have to beat and take over in order to speed boost. So that's another plus for this archetype, man. You can speed boost and take over. My ball control is a 79 right now. If I get one more bar, it'll be an 80 ball control, man. Just imagine that, 80 ball control, an 88 three ball, and a 99 mid-range. Like, bro, that's way better than a pure shot creator. A pure shot creator three ball only like a 79 or an 80. This dude three ball is an 88, you guys, I think. It might be higher than an 88. And my ball control maxed out at an 85, bro. So if I can get this ball control maxed out, with an 85 ball control, I know all I'll have to do is score one time and I can speed boost. But look, man, let's go and get into the build, bro. As you guys see, I'm trying to iso right here. I try to see was I able to speed boost yet. So I wasn't able to speed boost, but I end up hitting this man with a hop jump and getting that easy mid-range to go. Now, you guys, look at my takeover. I can speed boost right now, but they end up leaving my boy Trail wide open. So I'm going to go and give it to him, get them easy points in there. You feel me? Because I'm still trying to win. But you guys finna see me go crazy right here after this play, bro. As you see, one of they players quit. So I'm like, all right, bro. All we need is the ball back. And I'm finna show you boys what I mean by you need takeover to speed boost. As you see, they end up getting the foul right here. Really, I just wanted them to score, bro. Just because I wanted to use my takeover. Because I wanted to see what I can do with it. So as you see, I'm just jumping. We left the two-way sharp wide open. He missed. I don't know where I third at this moment. It's 3 versus 2, but it's all good. As you guys see, man, I'm in takeover now. I can speed boost just like a play sharp. I can break ankles. As you see, stepping back, bang! Like, I can do anything when I'm in takeover with this archetype. And I'm not gonna lie, I'm thinking about getting this archetype ball control up some more. Because playing with this archetype, to me, it's more fun than playing with my play sharp, bro. Just because I'm more dominant. Like, you feel me? They really gotta hold me now. Cause if I get clamped up, I can easily fade after he got that block. And this archetype gets some really good dunk packages too. When I was just looking through the dunks, it get a lot of dunks my play sharp don't even get. And I understand that because this is shot creating primary. But like I was saying, man, if I'm getting clamped up, I got difficult shots, Hall of Fame. And bro, if you are a 94 with this archetype, it'll be way better. This shot right here would have been green, but I missed it. If I would have been a 94 overall with this build, that shot right there would have been green. No cap. I'm already knowing it would have been green. But as you see, the score is 10 to 11. They gave me the ball back. Now, right here, I end up throwing up a dumb shot because I broke his ankles, bro.
Dumbass motherfucker.
I don't know what I was thinking on that play. I know. I sold the bad, bro. I should have never shot that shot. That was my fault. They got a 2 on the other end. They took a 1-point lead. So I was like, all right, man. It's time for me to get glitched. So I told Trail to come get the ball. I was going to do pick and pops and just glitch this dude because I knew he couldn't hold me. As you see, I'm going to the other side. Wide open. Bang! You feel me? That's another good thing about this archetype. You can glitch. Y'all know when them scratch bigs be glitching down on the D-pad, just going left, right, left, right. You can do that with this archetype, but it'll be 10 times faster. So as soon as you glitch, you're going to be wide open. You just got to get them right teammates that going to throw you the ball. You feel me? But they end up missing this layup right here. We got the ball. They follow. So I end up glitching him going straight to the corner. You already know that green. Like I said, bro, with this archetype, you can glitch 10 times faster because of your speed, man. But look, bro, the score is 12 to 17. I left him open. I wasn't paying attention. Now it's 15 to 17. So I'm like, all right, bro, I'm finna glitch again. But when she threw me the ball, the pass put me over there, and it made me get wide open. I did not glitch that time. It's just the pass pulled me over some. So I ended up being wide open. So now the score is 15 to 20. I don't know why Trev over here with my man. He leaving his man wide open for an easy shot, bro, and that goes in. The score is 17 to 20, and as you guys see, I got my takeover 2 times in 1 game, man. With Shot Craze, you get your takeover so fast, but as you see, I'ma end up in the air spin, jump a green light, bang! As you guys see, man, I had 20 points, 8 for 11, 4 for 5, I missed 1 3 on the game number 2. Now, in game number 2, bro, I let Trail set me up until I got takeover. Then when I got takeover, I just tried to go crazy. As you see, I end up wrapping around. I got a bounce back right here because I was lagging, but it still went in, making the score 3-0. But now they coming down court. He going to end up giving it to the center. The center going to get right by my center and coming in the paint and dunking. Ain't nothing I can do at that point, man. I'm too little for that. But like I said, at the end of the gameplay, I will show you guys how I made this archetype. I will show you guys the badges it get. And also, I will show you guys what the stats looking like. But they give me the ball. I'm going to do a hesitation behind the back. I'm going to throw it in my stretch, and I'm going to wrap around Trail right here to try to get wide open. He didn't follow me. Easy green light, man. Like, come on, bro. If you wide open with this archetype, it's a high chance that you're going to make majority of your shots. As you see, the score is now 6-2. So we just trying to play good defense right here to try to get a stop. The center gonna pass it back to him. He end up getting wide open. My center didn't pick up, so that was an easy two. So I'm gonna get a ball back to our point guard because I'm trying to wrap around and get an easy three so I can build toward my takeover so I can throw an ice on. But he end up getting ripped right here, man. But he end up stopping the fad break right here. This dude shot that dumb shot. And now it's our ball again. She gave it to Trail. Trail give it to me. So right here, I'm just trying to get a buck. I'm gonna do a little hesitation behind the back, going to the paint, easy dunk. Now, I saw my center wide open in the paint. I know you guys, I'm trying to get my takeover so I can throw an ISO on. I like the ISO, but this archetype is overpowered, bro. I'm trying to tell you guys. But they center end up getting blocked right here. Trail get the ball. Trail gonna throw the ball to me down court. You already know that's an easy dunk. Now I have takeover. So I'm finna throw an ISO on now. As you see, they went in the paint with a dumb layup, and he actually made it. So I was like, all right, bro, let me activate my takeover real quick and go crazy. I'm trying to break his ankles right here. So now I'm just spamming dribble moves just to have fun, because it feel good to, you feel me, be able to speed boost, and you ain't got to worry about missing because you is a shot creator. You can easily fade from three, fade from mid-range. If you a 94, you can shoot, bro. Like, this build is overpowered. You just got to get his overall up. But as you see, he fouled me right here, so I'm going to take the ball out. I'm going to come over here. I should have shot that shot. I don't know why I'm over dribbling, but he fouled me again. So I'm like, all right, bro, let me come back court and get it this time. So right here, I messed up my dribble move. As you guys see right there, I did not try to do that behind the back. And it just messed me up from all my combos. We got 6 seconds left, so I saw that. So I did that little hop jumper right there, and I'm going to go to the left side and fade. But I did not get this shot to fall, man. But it's all good, man. We back on defense. They went down court, got an easy two, making the score 11-12. Now it's just a one-point game. So I was saying, all right, man, I got to go and score. I throw it to my boy Trail. He wide open in the corner. He did not shoot that. I don't know why. He throws it back to me. So I'm going to do my little hesitation behind the back, go in the paint. This dude going to foul me. So now I'm taking the ball out. So I was like, all right, bro, y'all, we need a bucket. He left me wide open. I didn't get the ball the first time. So I'm like, all right, bro, we all good. I end up breaking his ankles. They left my stretch wide open. I passed it. She knocked down the shot, making the score 11-15. So all we need is a stop right here. He ended up throwing it to the center. That dude cut back door. I guess they didn't see it. So it's all good. I don't know what Trail doing. He tried to get that steal, man. He gonna get in the paint, get an easy layup. Now the score is 13-15. So I'm cherry picking. I'm all the way down court. Easy dunk, making the score 13-17. My boy Trail finally got that steal he wanted, bro. They gonna give me the ball right here. So I'm gonna do my little hesitation behind the back. Hesitation, end up pulling up. Bang! Making the score 13-20. So now you guys already know we won now, bro. We got that many stops just that quick. They coming down court. He wide open. He end up missing that shot. So I got the ball. Now I'm right here. I was trying to do a step back. They wouldn't let me. So I finally got that step back I needed, and I missed. Like, bro, I really missed that, but it's all good, man. We got the ball back. Score is still 13-20. So right here, I'ma just, hey, I gotta make up for that last three I missed, bro. You feel me? I gotta make up for it. As you guys see, 20 points, 8-10, 4-6. Now let's get into how I made this archetype, you guys. Alright, man, here go y'all boys, the build right here. So you wanna make him a shooting guard. Do not make this archetype a point guard. Do not make this archetype a small forward. Make him a shooting guard, bro. Based off the badges, he best at shooting guard. Now, for your primary skill, put shot creating. And for your secondary skill, put three-point shooting, man. Alright, here go the badges right here. You still get the 4 Hall of Fame shot creating badges. There go your gold badge. You get the sharp shooting badges, gold. Then here go your silver badge. You get limitless range, lob city finisher, acrobat, relentless finisher, drop step, anchor breaker. And here go your 4 bronze badges right here. So So in my opinion, this is the best shot creating build in the game. And I am finna show you guys what I did with the height, what I did with the wingspan, and what I did with the weight. So look, man, if you just wanna see that, here you go right here. All right, for the height, I kept him 6'4", because my ball control right now is a 79. So soon I will have an 80 ball control, so all I have to do is score one time to speed boost. So I kept mine 6'4", now for the weight, I put the weight all the way down. I put minimal weight because I don't care about contact dunk. I don't care about sprint. I don't care about box out. Like, why would you need any of that? You feel me? So for me, I put the weight all the way down, man. Lateral quickness, speed with ball, vertical, and acceleration, really all you need, to be honest. So I put the weight all the way down. And for the wingspan, I put minimum wingspan. And I'm finna go and show you guys the stats right now. So I put the wingspan all the way down as well. And I will be grinding this build to 94. But as you see, my open shot 3 is an 88. Your open shot mid-range is a 99. Your moving shot mid-range is a 96. And your contested shot mid-range is a 90. So like I was saying, man, this has to be the best shot creator build in the game. You just like a pure shot creator, except for your 3 ball is way higher. And as you guys see, your ball control also maxed out at 85. So I'ma soon have an 80 ball control. But here go the rest of the stats if you guys wanted to see. You're still 71, you feel me? Lateral quickness 79. Wait, you got an 80 vertical? Hold on, let me see what your driving dunk is. Your driving dunk is a 77. Hey man, I hope all y'all is having a blessed and wonderful day, bro. It's your boy Jay, and I'm out. Peace. Hey man, don't forget to subscribe, bro. What y'all doing?